southern Iowa. I've hunted this spot the past two nights, and I've seen 30 deer both nights. There's two shooters on this farm. There's a 6x6 that I can shoot, and a big 8-pointer. I'm hunting a friend of mine's farm and kind of just shooting his cold bucks, or trying to shoot one of them anyway. We've been seeing them every night. They've just been out of range. I shot the gun today, and I am dead nuts where I need to be at 100 yards, which puts my bullet drop compensator on out to 300, so my confidence is high. The weather's perfect. The pressure's at 30.4. There's a little bit of snow on the ground. It's been kind of breezy the last couple days, and it's still out here. You can hear a pin drop. So, my last night to get it done. Hopefully this buck makes a fatal mistake tonight. Follow along. Let's see how this season ends. Just spotted the buck I'm in here after, one of the two bucks I'm in here after. He's about 300 yards right now, but he's walking out of the woods straight to me, so he's kind of behind some brush. I just got a quick little glimpse of him. I'm going to try and get the camera on him if he steps out into this field, and hopefully he works in to give me a shot. There's some does meandering around up there too, so hopefully this high pressure and these calm winds gets him on the field early. But that's a good sign. He's here. I know he's here, and he was working this way. I just had that 6x6 broadside, and I had a dead rest, and he was at 200 yards on the money. But I couldn't drop the other window to get it on film, so I did not shoot him. It's still plenty early. It might work back out, but these does just come out and get so sketchy and leave. They chill out and they come back out. Mm-hmm. they were running. I don't know why these does in the field blew. They were just feeding out there. I don't see anything. They just started staring to the west. There's no vehicles on the road. There's nothing in the field. There's nothing. Oh, I could puke. Oh, man, that's so frustrating. That's so frustrating. That's probably going to wrap up my late muzzleloader season. It's just been such a struggle. This season, I have lost the most important farm to me that I've ever had the privilege of hunting. Two of the most important farms that I've ever had the privilege of hunting. Both the farms got sold. Been hunting them my whole life. Cody was gracious enough to let me come down here and hunt some of his deer. It's about an hour and a half drive from my house. This is the third time I've made the drive. And stayed for a few days, spent time away from the girls, and it's just one of those seasons, you know. Maybe that 200-yard shot was my opportunity, but when you're filming, you know, that's discipline, that you have to make the choice whether or not you're going to shoot. And there was no way it was going to be on film. None. I didn't have a window down. The camera wasn't on. He stepped out. He was broadside feeding. And I just didn't shoot, so. Well, it's a miracle. But they're coming back. Holy cow. I haven't seen any of the big bucks coming back yet, but I've got doe's starting to file out, so I've got 32 minutes left of legal shooting light, so the does are already in the field. There's two does in the field, and there's more walking straight at them, so hopefully a mature buck follows.
dropped him.
And that's how it goes sometimes late season. I have been on an emotional roller coaster tonight, up and down. I've been hunting this field, the same blind, the same deer for 3 days. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I said a prayer when all those deer blew off the field. I don't know what blew them, but they took off a long ways, and I thought my hunt was over. And I just sat here, I said, I'm gonna sit it out till the end and see what happens. And all of a sudden, the does just started piling out. And I was looking, I've spent more time in my binoculars tonight than anything, and there's a big old 8-pointer that came out, but he was missing half his rack. And then this deer is a deer Cody calls the old 10. We haven't been seeing him here. So, didn't really know he was around, but once I saw him, I could tell it was a really old, mature deer. And Cody's instructions were, if he's mature, I don't care what he is, as long as you don't shoot outlaw. So, that's what I stuck to. And just got it done. I shot my gun today at 100 to make sure it was on, and it was actually off, and I had to re-sight in. So, I mean, thank the Lord that I didn't shoot at anything and miss or wound anything, but I made sure that it was dead nuts today, and he was 207 yards when I shot him. Cody Wright, thank you. Casey, thank you. I cannot thank you guys enough. I've been dealt a world of blows this late season, which a lot of hunters go through. I've been so fortunate being able to hunt the places that I've hunted. And like I said, I lost some of the properties that mean the most to me, and haven't had that great of opportunities to hunt this late season. And Cody and Casey were kind enough to allow me to come down and hunt their farm and welcome me in their home. And man, I just can't thank them enough for the opportunity to get a hunt here. Cody's a great friend. Casey's a heck of a good cook, and I hope it's a friendship and an invite that I continue to get in the future. And I don't know how I'm gonna repay them, but I'm gonna try my hardest. So thank you guys for allowing me to come here and do this. You have no idea how much it means to me. Let's go get him. Well, guys, here he is. The buck Cody called the old 10. I hadn't been seeing him out here, but Cody had been showing me some pictures of him. Said he was a 140 type deer. Said he needed to go. And man, those deer spooked off. And I was so down in the dumps. And all of a sudden, I mean, I just stuck with it. And they just started coming right back through the timber about 40 minutes later. And he kind of came up the hill to run off this half-racked 8. There's just a pile of deer coming from everywhere. And I just want to thank everyone that's involved with this, that allows me to chase this dream and continue to do this. What a trophy. 140-inch type deer. I don't care about the score. I've always said that. I don't care what's on their head. Cody said this is a really, really old deer that needed to go, and I am more than happy to take him down. I can't say enough about the Kopfjäger Industries Reaper grip. I mean, I tied my CVA right into that thing. It was a 200-yard shot, 207 yards, and I dropped him right where he stood. I shot my gun today just to be sure, and man, I just couldn't be more thankful. So many people to thank on this. Casey, Cody, can't thank you guys enough. Thank you everybody watching for this Wildest Dreams TV. I want to continue bringing this to you guys. A 2-buck season. I'm so fortunate to harvest 2 old mature deer this year. One with my bow and one with the muzzleloader. I am so happy to end my season this way. Thank you guys for watching. Please stay tuned for more.